What is going on? My name is Ramesh. Welcome to another video on Mudgal's Musings, a channel dedicated to increasing your productivity. And if this is your first time here, consider subscribing and don't forget to hit that bell button so that you don't miss out anything exciting on this channel. I keep posting one video to help the teaching community as well as the parents and the others or anybody who is working in any other industry to help them increase their productivity. And you know, I've recently posted one video in which I've spoken about how the parents and the teachers can make use of various resources available online to continue with the learning program for their students in these times when the schools are likely to be closed for some time or an indefinite time, but the learning has to go on, the learning has to continue. Well, I am a member of the Commonsense community, and as a part of that, you know, I've received an email from the Commonsense community, as you can see over here. And this actually gives us some very interesting insights in terms of what are the web resources which are available where parents and the students and the teachers can make use of these web resources for continuing with education, engaging the students effectively and gainfully, so that even if the students are staying back or the children are staying back at home, they see a lot of value and their screen time is also used for effective and learning purposes. So to look at the recommendations given by this Commonsense community, the newsletter, the first thing they're talking about the media recommendations for entertainment. So essentially it lists out various applications and games for students, which are talking about music apps and games which will help the students engage, and in the process they are definitely going to learn something. And there are going to be some recommendations with respect to, you know, kids TV shows. There is a list of about 50 books all kids should read before they turn 12. So I'm sure, you know, this is going to be a very insightful idea for parents and the teachers as well. Best family movies, if you're staying together and if you're at home, you might want to check out some of the movies, because your child will not be obviously studying all the time. There is going to be time, a leisure time, a me time, in which you can actually watch these movies along with your kids. Well, Commonsense selections highlighting the best movies and TV shows is again another recommendation. These are mainly about music and the movies that you can as a family watch together, have fun, and in the process the students are also gainfully engaged and they are learning something new. Resources for at-home learning. If we have to explore these resources, we need to let me try checking out on this. I'm going to click on the 17 apps help kids stay focused. So this is more about how the parents can support their children to stay focused. So there are lots of these browse 17 apps to help kids stay focused. BFT Bear Focus Timer. Well, lots of apps are available over here. You might want to try them and check which one of them is going to be suitable for you and your child. And you might want to try them so that your child is able to stay focused on task at times. Moving on to the other home learning resources, apps that act like math and science tutors for homework help. Now let's check out what is there on this one. Well, this is talking about, alright, so let's see, Khan Academy definitely is a very obvious one. We have seen a lot of parents and students and schools and teachers are already using it. It's a very tried and tested program being funded by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, and they're doing a fantastic job of creating lots of learning content for the students. You know, it's like an online kind of a learning, and you can create an account and start accessing this. Math Space is another one, Math Papa, Algebra Calculator. I mean, a whole lot of things are there. You need to explore and figure out what suits you best. Now if we move on to the other apps, so I'm gonna, you know, copy paste this entire mail content into the description so that from there directly you're able to access these details. Already lots of on social media and in the newspapers and in other media as well, lots of inputs and advice and guidance is being provided, is being supplied to parents, students as well as teachers. In fact, many companies which provide the video conferencing facilities have also come forward to make the video conferencing available free for the students and the schools. Well, let's see how the situation is going to pan out. Schools are gearing up, the teachers are gearing up for meeting the requirements of learning, distance learning, where the teachers would be putting up lessons on a distance learning mode. The students can log on to making use of whatever tool the school is using, and they can log on to the classes and check out how and attend the classes, learn the content remotely, staying at home. In fact, they'll also be able to submit their assignments, their tasks, their work, their homework, and continue the learning uninterrupted. Hoping that we will all be able to fight this virus together and we will be emerging out of this. I'm confident the governments all over the world are doing everything possible to ensure that we are emerging as victors in this battle with the virus together. And well, that's all. That brings us to the end of this video. I hope you're going to explore these options or any other options. And yeah, before I put an end to this video, in case you have come across any of the resources, do mention them in the comment section so that the other parents also or other viewers also benefit. Till I see you next time, have a wonderful time ahead. Stay healthy and stay happy. Do protect yourself and your loved ones. Bye-bye. Take care.